What's up, YouTube? This video is brought to you by Webull. If you'd like to help out the channel and get 2 free stocks, make sure you check out my link below. Hey, I'm Chris Sain, and if you're new here, I make videos on personal finance and how to invest and build wealth through the stock market. I started this Robinhood challenge for 2 reasons. Number one, I wanted to simplify investing for those that wanted to invest but didn't quite know how. And number two, I wanted to show you guys in real time the companies that I invest in to grow my portfolio from $0 to 10K, and then eventually from 10K to 100K. So feel free to join me on the journey by grabbing some free stock using my link below, or sit back and watch. Either way, I appreciate you. Today's video, guys, is about the recovery stocks to buy this week. Okay, I did part one, and now today is part two. So guys, I need you to lock in on these 3 stocks for this week that I want you to at least establish a small position in or put on your watch list. But before we do that, let's take a look at my portfolio. Okay guys, as you can see, my portfolio is currently sitting at $48,296.94 on the day. Not really much is going on. On the week, we are up a little over 1%. On the month, we are up over 6.5%. If I take you guys 3 months out, we are up over 17.5%. If I take you guys 1 year out, we are up over 16%. You guys know I haven't had this account 1 year yet. And if I take you guys out all time, again, I'm over 16%. Listen guys, I started this account with $0 in January to show you guys how to properly build out your investment portfolio. So if you're new here, man, please like and subscribe and follow the journey on the road to 100K. If you've been here, let's do what we do. Today, guys, I want to talk to you about 3 stocks, in particular, 3 recovery stocks that I want to put on your radar this week. Number one being AMC, ticker symbol AMC Entertainment. You guys know the movie theaters. You guys already know what this is. Okay, listen, they were hit very hard with the whole pandemic. And so, again, I want us to start thinking strategically as we go back to school. As the NFL season start, I'm going to teach you some stuff that you're not going to hear on some other channels about strategic plays that I need you guys to be thinking about. Okay, the movie theaters has a deal that I want you guys to be cautious with this one, because if all goes well, this will be another home run. However, if another outbreak of corona hit and the movie theaters don't open back up August 20th, then this might be, instead of $5, this might be a $4 stock, okay? I already know it will double. So if you got money, $10,000, $5,000, $1,000, we're going to double your money. I'm not concerned about that. I'm concerned about how the rest of the world of things we can't control might impact this investment choice. So I need you guys to be paying attention to the news. I need you guys to be paying attention to the communities you live in to see, man, is there an uptick in this COVID stuff? Is it going down? Will this impact this investment I'm making, AMC? Okay, so if it goes as planned, then again, we can double and reach our 52-week high in this, which is over $12. But if not, guys, this one might continue to trade sideways. So just keep that in mind if you choose to go with this AMC play. Stock number 2 today is Best Buy. Listen guys, this is the one I'm gonna be heavily in. If it's overpriced for some of you, don't worry about it. This is a low price in the game of stocks. But everyone returning back to school, getting computers, working from home, going to school from home, watching the NFL, getting their sound systems together, Best Buy has the potential to really take off. Again, stores like them, still in my neighborhood even, they've been shut down. They only do curbside pickup. And so with the school year beginning, with the NFL season beginning, sports in general coming back at the professional level, you have to be thinking about what will possibly or potentially take off. Best Buy is one I'm taking a flyer on. So if you guys do this one, consider this one as well. I would say around the 108 mark or below. Okay, if you can get this for $108 or below, go in. Same with AMC. If you can get AMC for $5.50 or below, consider your position in that one. Stock number 3 is American Airlines. Listen, guys, all airline plays are fair game right now. So if you got Southwest, if you got Delta, if you got Spirit, those are good as well. In terms of making my list for the top 3 today, I went with American Airlines. And so I want you guys to keep in mind, all those airline plays are good. The cruise lines are as well, but I did those last week. So to this week, I'm covering airlines, okay? For airlines, American is what I want you guys to consider. Again, Southwest is the best airlines around, so don't get it twisted. This is not about that. Investment sometimes is about what logically will pop, what logically makes sense. Okay, if I want you guys to have an airline for the long haul, of course I'm going to say make sure you have and own Southwest as a part of your airline portfolio. Okay, but for this particular play, I'm telling you guys, American Airlines is the one that has the room to run. Check this out really quickly. The 52-week high on this one is $31.67. So all we need for it to do is go to $26 for it to double our money. If it goes to 31 or reaches 52-week high, which again, upon a vaccine, all those things are possible, we hit another home run. And so guys, I'm making this very simple and plain because I want to see you guys hit it out the park this week as well as next week, okay? So listen, man, those are the top three picks for today. Make sure, if nothing else, you at least put them on your watch list. And if they reach the price point that you like, make sure you pounce all over it. Hey, next up, we have our word of the day. And our word of the day is value stocks. Guys, I told you I was gonna take you down through there, man. Yesterday, I talked to you guys about growth stocks. Today, I wanna talk to you about value stocks. Value stocks are nothing else but somewhat what I would call a proven winner. They don't make my definition of a proven winner, but in reality, they are proven winners. They are your for real household names. Johnson & Johnson, Pepsi, Coke, McDonald's, Walmart. Things like that are, you can't go wrong investing in those stocks. I do recommend you have them as part of your portfolio, but when you're trying to grow your portfolio like we're doing on this channel, we're trying to go from 0 to 10K, and then we hit 10K, now we're trying to go from 10K to 100K. I have no room for value stocks like that outside of AT&T, but because AT&T is a dividend aristocrat, I rock with AT&T and they pay me huge money every quarter. However, even though the other ones do as well, I'm not trying to hold that many of them because I have a goal in mind of what I'm trying to do and what I'm trying to teach. And so value stocks are good, but just know they move a little slower, okay? They're not growing like Tesla, 300 to 1700. They're not growing like Apple, 150 to 340. They're not going like Facebook, you know what I'm saying? And so keep those things in mind. If you do hold those, know that your money is safe in them though. And like I always say, it's better to invest in those than banks and things like that. If you do want to low-key hide your money, y'all, that's what us investors do. We don't use banks like that, okay? So keep that in mind, but understand what you're getting when you buy that. You're getting great quality, you're getting a possible good dividend, but you're not going to get that much growth, at least not like you're going to get with the stocks that we talk about on this channel. Up next, guys, we have our question of the day, and our question of the day comes from Tim W. He says, hey Chris, every morning at 7:45 I watch your video, and at 8 I check the markets. I've learned so much about the market through you, and thank you for caring about the average investor. Your teaching and knowledge is awesome. My question is, what does it mean when you see a company show a negative dividend payment? Hey Tim, great question, man. I thank you for this comment. I thank you for sending this in. Listen guys, as a dividend investor, I think it's important for you to know this. Just like we can make money every month, our money can also decrease every month. We won't lose money, but it can decrease. Why? Because of what Tim just kind of alluded to. Sometimes, based on the economy, based on how that business is performing, your dividend paying company may get cut. You guys know I'm a heavy Wells Fargo guy. Wells Fargo pay 51 cent per share. However, they cut their dividend down to 10 cent and I had to get rid of it. Dividend stocks sometimes do make cuts. A once in a lifetime event like a pandemic is reason for dividends to get cut. So if you see a negative sign, that means two things. Either it got cut, meaning from it was this price, now it was this price, or they're no longer paying a dividend right now. They're trying to save their money so the company can stay afloat until they find their footing when this pandemic clears, okay? So if that happens with some of the stocks that you own, don't freak out, don't panic, but do make a wise decision about whether or not you will choose to move on from the stock, hold the stock, or ride it out through the current phase it might be going through. So again, Tim, great question. I think that's good for you guys to know. Listen, if you have questions, leave them in my comments below. I'll grab them and add them to my next video. Listen, I make videos like this every week, so if you like this one, make sure you check out the next one. Remember, most people see the end result. Very few consider the journey. Do me a favor. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Make sure you grab some free stock using my link below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.